Hi, my name is Rishi Nikolai, and in this short video, we will be talking about the opportunity generative AI brings to help people create attention-harnessing behaviors and combat digital distractions. A distraction is any event or stimulus that diverts our attention away from getting work done. Though sometimes distractions can provide a break in intense work environments, at the wrong time, auditory and visual distractions, like notifications and cognitive distractions caused by work overload and poor time management, cause significant loss in productivity. The more distractions employees experience in their work, the lower their control over their effectiveness. According to research done by Sophie Leroy, employees who are regularly distracted have fewer cognitive resources available to finish their outstanding work tasks. A survey conducted by EMI Research Solutions found that 87% of employees believe that digital distractions cause a significant loss in workplace productivity. Dr. Gloria Mark at the University of California found that an average person spends 7,620 minutes a year just trying to refocus their attention after being distracted. Putting that in context, that is nearly a trip to the moon and back for the Apollo mission. Or if you're a manager with a team of 8 people, that is 136 days a year spent on refocusing your attention, mainly because of digital distractions. In fact, our attention is critical to adopting new technologies, being creative, and collaborating with others to achieve business outcomes. Without our attention, generative AI itself cannot achieve productivity outcomes. This is why Microsoft believes that human attention is the most scarce and valuable commodity people have. It is the foundation of getting work done, as well as creating memorable moments with our friends and family. Alas, digital overload, illusion of multitasking, instant gratification, over-dependence on digital devices, and the complexity of modern life all contribute to our reduced attention span. Daniel Kahneman, in his book Thinking Fast and Slow, outlined System 1 and System 2 as the two conceptual systems driving our cognitive processes. He also described that our brains are very inefficient at task onboarding, where lots of cognitive resources are used to gain context before the task is performed. While the fast automated tasks take less neural resources, our slow, more deliberate processes like designing a good AI prompt require considerably larger neural resources. And then our brains are also terribly inefficient at task offboarding. The real challenge is the emotional value we unconsciously assign to the outcomes of these tasks that cause us to ruminate. Less for our System 1 tasks, but for our System 2 tasks, these thoughts end up occupying our attention well after we have finished performing them. And given that our brains are incapable of simultaneously processing two or more jobs, when we are trying to multitask, this cognitive noise just gets exponentially worse, causing us to feel fatigue, stress, increase errors in task, reducing productivity, and can even negatively impact relationships with people at and outside of work. Because neuropsychology is perhaps not everyone's cup of tea, we have also tried to explain this concept using a geometry syllabus. Say we are at point A, and we're trying to get to point B to complete a task. Basic law of physics says that the shortest distance between any two points is a straight line. In an ideal world, this is how our attention should be spent on getting tasks completed. Now, this is the best case scenario. Often we get interrupted when getting work done, a distraction event which takes our attention away in a different direction, taking up valuable time. This distraction can be a technology-initiated distraction, like a notification, or if working from home, a beep of the washing machine, indicating that the cycle has finished and clothes need to be dried. Depending on how off-topic the distraction is, the degree of distraction signifies how divergent your attention starts to travel in time. However, all is not lost. Sooner or later, we all realize that we have drifted and we need to get our attention back on track. The trick is to inject a remediation event, which gets you back on task quickly and course corrects you enough so you don't lose any more time. So let's recap the two important points that we have covered so far. In order for us to stay in the flow of work and improve our productivity, we need to have more distraction prevention and quick attention remediation to get the outcomes we are hoping to achieve. This is because each distraction has a cost in time, which can be theoretically calculated. And there is also a larger loss of value that occurs during that period, as that time is no longer retrievable. In reality, things are a little bit more complex. In this attention-based economy, everything around us is competing for our attention for as long as possible. When digital distractions secure our attention to break the flow of work, that is when we have fallen into the trap of a digital distraction behavior. Before we can find a remediation event, the stimuli around us often introduces us to the next distraction, and then the next distraction, and so on and so forth, till our attention needs significant effort to go back to the direction of getting our original outcome achieved. This causes fragmentation of our attention and results in mental exhaustion. For many of us, starting a new task where new content is required can be overwhelming. Many of us suffer from a writer's block, which results in things being delayed till we can find more inspiration. The other common challenge is the rise of the early distraction. Once the mind gets used to being distracted, it makes it easier for it to continue to get distracted. This can be explained by Harry Harlow's learning set phenomena, a result of the brain's neuroplasticity. So we really want to avoid early distractions or any distractions altogether till the task is completed. This is where the Copilot stack and the Microsoft 365 Copilot brings the biggest opportunity for modern work in a generation. It not only helps us address inertia by creating the initial content, it also actively prevents distractions by the ability to feed us answers to complex questions using prompt engineering. This, in return, can reduce the likelihood of distractions. But telling people to adopt new technologies is not enough to creating repeatable behaviors over the long term, as people are impacted by unconscious biases, a natural biological phenomena. While many people struggle to let go of the personal and relational power that comes from the informational and political systems within their workplaces, others may struggle to let go of the inefficient ways of working, just because that is how things have been done for a very long time. Readily available disinformation and misinformation around generative AI can also trigger availability bias. And then people seek more information to align to their perspectives, limited by confirmation bias. While addressing status quo bias requires people to have a clear what's in it for me, which training alone can't address, some people look at occasionally hallucinations of generative AI technologies as the reason for why it can't be trusted. Our role as productivity leaders is to help people overcome these unconscious biases by helping them adopt attention-harnessing behaviors, showing real-world value. While previous technologies provided some business value from their deployment and usage. Microsoft 365 Copilot requires deep, habitual usage that delivers measurable value to the employee, to the line of business, and the whole organization itself. This is how organizations can set themselves up for the ultimate proficient use of this constantly evolving opportunity. Change management is a critical enabler for people to adopt new ways of working. ProSci's research in change management demonstrates that organizations that have excellent change management practices are 7 times more likely to meet or exceed project objectives compared to organizations that have poor change management practices. ProSci's ADKA framework also suggests that people need to have the awareness for the importance of the Copilot initiative within the organization, then decide to participate in it by seeing the value for them before training can be effectively received. While sponsors deliver the organizational-wide value messages, line managers are critical in helping to build individual ability around the use of generative AI and help staff realize value by the right reinforcement techniques. Microsoft has created a 4-step implementation journey for Microsoft 365 Copilot and other Microsoft 365 applications, which is specifically designed to help organizations put into practice the necessary people implementation steps. This approach has been embedded in the Copilot Success Kit, and we will continue to align our approach better with customer success journeys, which in return will enable organizations to achieve their Copilot-enabled outcomes. As people are biologically wired to think in a step-by-step manner, there are also costs of skipping steps when performing change management activities. For organizations to be able to maximize their opportunity to deliver benefits associated with Copilot Stack, it is suggested that each staff member be taken through their individual change journeys, scaled organizational-wide using effective change management strategies. This will ensure that while people change at different paces, that we bring each employee along the business change journey, and everyone gets to contribute to the exponential growth opportunities that Copilot technology offers. This is the core principle of Microsoft's people-first approach, supported by the modern collaboration architecture, assisting with the which Copilot when, wrapped by the right security, governance, and compliance capabilities of Microsoft's cloud technologies. For more information, please visit the Modern Collaboration Architecture website and enjoy sharing all the amazing opportunities and success stories within your organization and with the wider community. Thank you all for your time and your valuable attention.